Hello dear students, in this session let us study the concept of solution of Laplace equation in cylindrical coordinate. So first I will write the Laplace equation. Del square u is equal to dou square u by dou x square plus dou square u by dou y square plus dou square u by dou z square is equal to 0. This is my Laplace equation in three dimensional. Correct. So now let us first consider the Laplace equation in cylindrical coordinate system. Del square u is equal to urr plus 1 over r into ur plus 1 over r square into u theta theta plus uzz is equal to 0. This is nothing but in cylindrical coordinate system we are considering our Laplace equation. I can write this as dou square u by dou r square plus 1 over r into dou u by dou r plus 1 over r square into dou square u by dou theta square plus dou square u by dou z square is equal to 0. Now you can observe here my u is a function of r, theta and z, r comma theta comma z. I will call this as equation number 1. Since we will solve this equation using separation of variable method, I will assume the solution in the form u of r comma theta comma z is equal to f of r comma theta and z of z. I will call this as equation number 2. So solution of equation 1 is of the form equation 2. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to find out dou square u by dou r square, dou u by dou r, dou square u by dou theta square and dou square u by dou z square using your equation number 2. So what I will get, dou square u by dou r square is, first let me find out dou u by dou r. Here f is a function of r and theta and z is a function of z. Since it is a product, it is in product form, I should use product rule for differentiation. So I will retain z as it is. If you differentiate f with respect to r, you will get f dash. Or I can write dou f by dou r. So now what is dou square u by dou r square? Z into dou square f by dou r square. Similarly, I should find out dou square u by dou theta square. Dou square u by dou theta square is nothing but z into dou square f by dou theta square, since f is a function of r as well as theta. Okay, similarly, what is dou square u by dou z square? It is, I should retain f as it is, since f is independent of z, into dou square z by dou z square. So now what you have to do, you should substitute all this value in your equation number 1. What you will get, z into dou square f by dou r square plus 1 over r into dou f by dou r into z plus 1 over r square into z into dou square f by dou theta square plus f into dou square z by dou z square is equal to 0. Now let's find out what is this dou square z by dou z square using separation of variable method. That means you should equate each term with same constant, correct? So before that, since this dou square z by dou z square is multiplied with f, I will divide my whole equation with 1 by f. If you divide, what you will get, and since there is z in each term, I will take z outside. So you will get z by f into dou square f by dou r square plus 1 over r into dou f by dou r plus 1 over r square into dou square f by dou theta square plus 1 over z into d square z by dz square, because z is depending on small z only. There is no more than two independent variable, so I am using ordinary differential notation. Okay, is equal to 0. You can write this as dou square f by dou r square plus 1 over r into dou f by dou r plus 1 over r square into dou square f by dou theta square into 1 by f is equal to minus d square z by dz square into 1 over z. This is equal to some constant, say k. Okay. This k is nothing but your separation constant. Separation constant. So now let's find the value of z. I can write this as d square z by dz square plus k into z is equal to 0. I will call this as equation number 3. Now your k takes 3 values. One is equal to 0, greater than 0 and less than 0. Okay. If k is greater than 0, that means real and positive, what you will get? Your auxiliary equation will be m square plus lambda square is equal to 0. That is, m is equal to plus or minus I into lambda. So z will be c1 cos lambda z plus c2 into sin lambda z. If k is less than 0, your auxiliary equation will become m square minus lambda square is equal to 0. That is nothing but m is equal to plus or minus lambda. So z is c3 e power lambda z plus c4 e power minus lambda z. If k is equal to 0, you will integrate this term twice. I will write the solution directly. You will get C5Z plus C6. While solving wave equation as well as heat equation, we were considering where you will get a solution such that your output should be in wave form, correct? But here what we will consider is to the solution which decays with increasing z. If you increase the value of z, your solution should decay. That means if you increase the value z up to as z tends to infinity, what will happen to your capital Z? You will get it as 0. So your z decays there. That means you have to consider this solution. That means in the case of k is less than 0. So k is less than 0 means you have taken k is equal to minus lambda square. So your equation, this equation becomes dou square f by dou r square plus 1 over r into dou f by dou r plus 1 over r square into dou square f by dou theta square plus lambda square f is equal to 0. Here I have substituted the value minus lambda square. So if I take this minus lambda square to my left hand side, you will get it as plus lambda square. Okay. I will call this as equation number 5. Now observe. Since f is a function of both r and theta, I will assume this solution will be in the form of f of r into h of theta. Okay. Now what you should do? You should find out dou square f by dou r square, dou f by dou r, and dou square f by dou theta square using your equation star and substitute in equation number 5. So dou f by dou r will be, h is constant, that means h is a function of theta, so I will retain as it is. If you differentiate f with respect to r, you will get dou f by dou r. I will denote that as h into f dash. So dou square f by dou r square will be h into f double dash, and dou square f by dou theta square will be f into h double dash. So substitute these values in your equation number 5. F double dash into h plus 1 over r into f dash of f dash into h plus 1 over r square into f h double dash plus lambda square. This f is nothing but f into h is equal to 0. Now divide whole equation by f into h. You will get f double dash by f plus 1 over r into f dash by f plus 1 over r square into h double dash by h plus lambda square is equal to 0. Now I should find the solution for h. Since h is multiplied with 1 over r square, divide whole equation by r, sorry, multiply whole equation by r square. You will get r square into f double dash plus r into f dash plus lambda square r square into f into 1 over f is equal to minus h double dash by h. If you simplify this, you will get this terms only. Okay. Now I should equate this term to some constant, and I will call that constant as k dash. Here k dash is nothing but your separation constant. Since your h is a function of theta, your periodic solution should be in sinusoidal waveform. That means it should consist of trigonometric functions, correct? And you will get that trigonometric function only in the case of k dash is greater than 1. That means you will call that k dash is equal to n square. I will write the solution directly. You will get h is equal to c3 cos n theta plus c4 sin n theta. When you will get this solution in the case of k dash is greater than 0, that means k dash is equal to n square. Now your equation, this equation becomes r square into d square f by dr square plus r into df by dr plus lambda square r square minus n square into f is equal to 0. Okay. So if you observe this equation is a Bessel equation with order n. So we have a general solution for this equation. That general solution is f is equal to a into jn of lambda r plus b into yn of lambda r. Here jn of lambda r is Bessel function of kind 1 or first kind, and yn is Bessel function of second kind. with order n. We know that this yn of lambda r, yn of lambda r tends to minus infinity as r tends to 0. So we choose b is equal to 0. This all things I have explained in solving wave equations. Okay, you can go through that once again for the better clarification. So your f will become a into jn of lambda r. Now the final solution become u of r comma theta comma z is equal to a into jn of lambda r into c1 e power lambda z plus c2 e power minus lambda z into c3 cos n theta plus c4 sin n theta. I have just substituted all the values in your equation number 2. That's it. So this is the general solution of Laplace equation in cylindrical coordinate system. Now let's move to one more topic, that is solution of Laplace equation in spherical coordinate. Before we have studied for cylindrical coordinate, now let's study for spherical coordinate system. Okay, the general solution will be of the form del square u is equal to dou by dou r into r square dou u by dou r plus 1 over sine theta dou by dou theta of sine theta dou u by dou theta plus 1 over sine square theta into dou square u by dou phi square is equal to 0. I will call this as equation number 1. This is your three-dimensional Laplace equation in spherical coordinate system. Now I have to assume the solution form, correct? The solution form will be solution in the form of u of r comma theta comma phi is equal to r of r into f of theta comma phi. Here your solution is a combination of r and f, and r is a function of r, whereas f is a function of theta as well as phi. Okay. So now what I should do? I should find out values and I should substitute in equation number 1. Del square. Okay, no need to write del square again and again. So if you differentiate, what you will get? Dou u by dou r in the place of dou u by dou r, f into dou by dou r into r square dou r by dou r plus 1 over sine theta, I will take it as r. Since I am differentiating with respect to theta, your r will be constant. So I have written r here into dou by dou theta as it is. Sin theta I will retain as it is. Dou u by dou theta will be dou f by dou theta plus 1 over sin square theta into dou square u by dou phi square will be r into dou square f by dou phi square is equal to 0. Now using separation of variables, you can find the solution. You can rewrite this equation in this form. What I have done is, since here your f, it is a depending on r only, I have converted your partial differential into ordinary differential. So I have just written this part as it is, d by dr into r square dr by dr, in these two terms r is common, so I have taken that r outside, that should be here, so I have taken to my left hand side with denominator, so it became 1 over r. This f I have taken to my right hand side, so it became 1 over f. So in these two terms, 1 over sin theta into dou by dou theta of sin theta into dou f by dou theta, it is sin square theta, so sin theta into sin theta is sin square theta into dou square f by dou phi square. Okay, these two term is equal to some constant, that is separation constant, say minus mu. Okay, now this part will become 1 over r into d by dr of r square dr by dr is equal to minus mu. Remaining part, this minus and this minus will get cancelled, so you will get 1 over f into sin theta into dou by dou theta of sin theta into dou f by dou theta plus 1 over sin theta into dou square f by dou phi square is equal to mu. Now I should solve these two equations. I will call this as, this is my equation number 2, this is equation number 3, and this is equation number 4. Now from equation 3, you can write equation 3 as, just consider this part. So you have to differentiate these two terms with respect to r. This is product of differentiation you can use here. So it will become r square d square r by dr square plus 2r into dr by dr. You can shift this r to your right hand side, so it is minus r mu. If you take to your left hand side, it will become plus mu into r is equal to 0. So if you observe this equation carefully, this is your Cauchy's Euler equation. So you have to use the transformation r is equal to e power z. This equation becomes d into d minus 1 plus 2d plus mu, that is nothing but d square plus d plus mu is equal to 0. Now you have to solve this equation. You can solve this using Schrader's formula. So I will write the solution directly. Minus 1 plus or minus square root of 1 minus 4 mu divided by 2. This is what you will get if you solve using Schrader's formula. Now I will choose some value to my mu. I can take any value. So arbitrarily I am choosing mu is equal to minus alpha into alpha plus 1. Substitute this value in your d and simplify it. You will get d is equal to minus 1 plus or minus square root of 1 plus 4 alpha square plus 4 alpha divided by 2. So this is nothing but minus 1 by 2 plus or minus 2 alpha plus 1 whole square by 2. Because this is in the form of a square plus b square plus 2ab. Now minus 1 by 2 plus or minus 2 alpha plus 1 divided by 2. If you solve even more, you will get minus 1 by 2 plus or minus alpha plus 1 by 2. This is nothing but your value d. Okay. That means you have two values for your d. If you solve this again, what you will get? D is equal to minus 1 by 2. If I choose plus, half of gets cancelled, so you will get one value as alpha. Another value is minus of alpha plus 1. So you have two values for your d. That means your solution is distinct. So r is equal to c1 e power r plus c2, sorry, r power alpha, and c2 r power minus of alpha plus 1. Okay, I will write it again. R is equal to c1 r power alpha plus c2 r power minus alpha plus 1. Why you are getting like this? Because you have used Euler's equation, Cauchy's Euler equation. Okay. Now, if you substitute minus mu is equal to alpha into alpha plus 1 in your equation number 4, you will get dou by dou theta into sin theta dou f by dou theta plus 1 over sin theta into dou square f by dou theta dou phi square plus alpha into alpha plus 1 f into sin theta is equal to 0. Since your f is a function of both theta and phi, I will define a function f as h of theta into capital phi of small phi. So now again you have to substitute these values in the above equation. You will get sin theta by h into d by d theta of sin theta dh by d theta plus alpha into alpha plus 1 sin theta h is equal to minus 1 over capital phi into d square phi by d phi square is equal to some constant I will choose as nu square. Now if you solve this, that means your equation will be d square phi by d phi square plus nu square phi is equal to 0. Okay, if you solve this, you will get a solution when nu is positive, that is c3 cos nu phi plus c4 sin nu phi. Similar procedure as we did in wave equation. Okay, so the remaining part of the equation is sin theta by h into d by d theta of sin theta into dh by d theta plus alpha into alpha plus 1 into sin theta into h is equal to nu square. If nu is equal to 0, your equation becomes, if nu is equal to 0, this equation becomes d by d theta of sin theta into dh by d theta plus alpha into alpha plus 1 sin theta into h is equal to 0. So now transforming the independent variable theta to x, okay, by choosing x is equal to cos theta, this equation becomes, if you choose x is equal to cos theta, this equation becomes d by dx of sin theta into dh by dx into dx by d theta plus into dx by d theta. That means this dx dx get cancelled, you will get d by d theta itself. Here dx dx gets cancelled, you will get dh by d theta itself. This is nothing but chain rule of differentiation. Plus alpha into alpha plus 1 into h is equal to 0. Okay. Oh, sorry. Here you have sin theta also, correct? Sin theta into h is equal to 0. So d by dx into, I can write sin theta as 1 minus cos square theta into dh by dx. Why this is 1 minus cos square theta? Because if you differentiate dx by d theta, you will get sin theta. Sin theta becomes sin square theta. So you can express sin square theta as 1 minus cos square theta into dh by dx plus alpha into alpha plus 1 into h is equal to 0. Using this substitution, you can write this equation as d by dx of 1 minus x square into dh by dx plus alpha into alpha plus 1 into h equal to 0. This is nothing but your Legendre equation. So you have a general solution for the Legendre equation, that is h is equal to c5 p alpha of x plus c6 q alpha of x. This is Legendre function of first kind, and this is Legendre equation of second kind. If alpha is equal to n, this equation becomes c5 p n of cos theta plus c6 p n of sin theta. Sorry, it's cos theta. So now we got h, phi as well as r. So substitute h and phi here. Okay, and substitute this f and r in your equation number 2. So that will be your final solution. Okay. So u of r comma theta comma phi is equal to c1 r power alpha plus c2 r power minus of alpha plus 1 into c3 into c5 pn of cos theta. Why this is c3? Because here we are considering the case when nu is equal to 0. So if nu is equal to 0, cos phi is 1 and sin phi becomes 0. So for phi you have a solution that is a constant, say c3. Okay. Here in Legendre equation, your pn cos theta becomes 0. So you will get only c5 pn cos theta. So this is the final solution for your Laplace equation in spherical form. Thank you.